Hi everyone, welcome back. I'm Saurabh Parikh. In the previous video, we have learned SAP Cloud Platform portal service concept, and we have seen how to set up an initial environment to create portal site. In this video, we will add few widgets, configure the layout of it, and design the portal site. Now let me quickly go to our previous site. As you are aware, we have already created our first site with the content of Hello World. Now let me go into that. We'll try to modify the same site. Let me go to menus. Now let me try to add one more page. This time I'm going to add anchor navigation page, and let me give the name as job core. Let's click on add. Now our job core page has been added. Let me go to menu section. I will click on edit, and we will add plus from here. We'll add one more item. Let me give the name as home. Item type will be page, and I will give the selected page as job code this time. Let me click on add. Now the home page has been added and it will be visible in our portal site. Now let me disable the menu page. I can click on remove from menu. Let me add one more page into the home. I'll click on add item. Let me give the display name as my apps. And this time I will select the launchpad. Now let me click on save. Now let me go back to my pages. As you can see, our job core page and launchpad is now enabled. Now let me set my job core as a home page. Here we have added our job core page as anchor navigation, so it will come with pre-structured layout. These are nothing but different from widgets. If you want, we can remove any widget. Let's say I do not want menu item widget. I can click on delete. Now let's say I would like to add a header section in this area. I can click on plus button. So it will load few widgets for me. So you can see there is a widget for list. We can add few cards. We can add a widget for carousel. So let me try to add a carousel widget. Let me click on plus button for headline carousel. So it will add a section like this. In headline carousel, we can change the image and text, which we will do it in the later part. Now let me go to section 1, and I will add few more widgets in the sections. So let me click on plus, and I will add header with titles. I will add one more widget in this section for align with cards. Let me go to section 2, and I will add two more widgets in this section. And in the section 3, also we will add widgets like this. Now we have added all the widgets which are required to build our site. Now let me try to change the image and title of this widget. So for that I need to click on edit widget. It will allow us to replace the images and modify the content. To make it easy, I have already downloaded few of the images. Now let me click on replace. Let me select header 01. Let me change the title of our website to Welcome to Job Corps. Similarly, we will add one more image with the content item 2. Let me change the image to header 02. Let me change the light title to Let Us Help You. Let me change the text with some meaningful lines. In our example, we do not require our third content. We can delete it from here. Now, so as you can see, we have added two widgets and I'll click on save. Now our header section is ready. Let me modify our section 1. Let me click on edit button. In this content, we will change our title. And subtitle. Click on save. Now let me add our align story card widget. In the content item 1, I will replace the title, text, and images. Let me change the title to We Are Local. To save the time, I have already written the text in a notepad file. I will simply copy it and replace it. I'll go to item 2. Change the title to We Are Experienced. And replace the text with our pre-written text. Similarly, we will do for content item 3 also. And I will click on save. So our section 1 is added. Let me click on section 2 and edit the section. Let me leave the subtitle blank. And in the center story card, I will add few more images. Let me change the title to Explore Job Corps Services. I'll replace the text with some meaningful text. And we'll change the image to our custom image. Let me change the display text to view services. I'll go to section 2. I'll change the title to view available jobs. And I'll replace the text with our pre-written text. And let me change the display text to view positions. Now let me add one more section in this item and change the title to stay connected. And text to our pre-written text. Let me change the image. And text to contact us. Now, after editing, I click on save. Our section 2 is also ready now. Let me go to section 3 and click on edit. I will change the image with our company logo and save. Let me change the icon cards. I'll add a title for keep in touch. Let me change the icons. Here I'm going to use SAP predefined icons. If you would like to know more about SAP icons, you can go to new tab and search with Icon Explorer. And here you can go with SAP icons, SAP Fiori tools, SAP business suites, and few more guidelines. Let me add the link for Facebook. In the URL section, you can provide your complete URL. For now, I'm going to leave it as blank. Let me go to content item 2, change the title to company. Change the text to other text. Content item. In content item 3, I will add the title as website. We'll change the logo. And links. Now let me click on save. Now let me go back to our section 1. This time I will select the settings icon. So here we can change the order of content. We can also change the background and dimension based on our requirement. Based on your requirement, you can change the layout of your sections with row or custom. For now, let me keep it to column layout only. We can also arrange our widgets and change the number. Let me go to dimensions. For now, I will keep the dimension margin to 5 pixel only. I will change the content width to full and minimum height let it be default. Let me click on save. We will go to section 2 and click on settings button. Here also we will keep the content layout as column and widgets in this manner only. We'll go to dimension and change our content width to full. Let me go to section 3. I'll again click on settings. In this section, let us change our layout to custom so that we can determine the arrangement of our widgets. Now, let's say I want my image to occupy only 1/4 of the screen size. So I can change to 1/4 into the desktop section and small link cast to 3/4. So with this change, my image will take 1/4 of the screen width size and small icons will take up the rest. Let me go to dimensions. Here I will change the margin to 100 pixels and content width to 1366. Let me click on save. So it will look something like this. Now let us configure the layout of widgets. Let me go back to my section 1 and click on align story card. Now let me click on settings icon. Here I can give the height, width, margin and alignment of my complete widget. Let me change the dimension. Here I can change the dimension of my widget. Let me change the item height to 27 rem, width to 18 rem and margin to 4 rem and let it be on the center side. I will click on save. Let me go to section 2 and on the center story card, I will click on settings. Here, let me provide the item height as 30 rem, width as 20 rem and margin to 4 rem. You can also see the preview on your right side. Now let me go to section 3 and I'll click on small icon links card and I'll click on settings. Here I'll change the height to 20 rem. Let me keep the width to 275 pixel and margin will remain to 0 area and I click on save. Now we are done with the changes. Let us quickly review the site. So this is how our site will look like. That's it for this video. In the next video, we will create one UEFI application, connect it with data source and integrate in the portal with Launchpad. And we will add that into the My App section. Thank you for listening and do not forget to like, share and subscribe to UTech Academy.